Welcome to Who the F***, the show that aims to take a deep dive on some of the acts announced for Reading and Leeds Festival 2019. Today we'll be looking at CamelPhat, a DJ duo from Liverpool who have had a pretty good 2017 and 2018 in terms of dance acts. If you've never heard of them before, hopefully this video will help answer the question, who the F*** are CamelPhat? That's what you're coming for, but they don't want to let you in it. You drop your bag to the floor and you're asking what's happening. And it's getting late now, hey now, enough of the arguments. Well, she sips the Coca-Cola, she can't tell the difference yet. CamelPhat, aka Dave and Mike, are a British DJ duo from Liverpool in the north of the UK. Can't think of any other really popular people that have ever come from Liverpool. An interesting fact about CamelPhat is they're made of two guys, Dave and Mike. Mike Descala was the engineer for the song Pretty Green Eyes by Ultra Beat. Which was a huge track in 2003. Genre-wise, I would describe them as a good old-fashioned Ibiza house, a defected fan's wet dream. They definitely take influence from people like MK, the Chemical Brothers, and some of the kind of dance floor production of Calvin Harris. They definitely fit into that same kind of camp as Gorgon City and Jax Jones, which is really, really popular in the UK at the moment. But they burst into the mainstream in 2017 with their collaboration with Elderbrook on the song Cola. She sips a Coca-Cola, she can't tell the difference yet. That's what you're coming for. Which ended up being Grammy nominated and went platinum both in the UK and Australia. Personally, I think I prefer their follow-up single, Panic Room. Welcome to the Panic Room. Which came out earlier this year. I much preferred that. I listened to that a lot more than listened to Cola anyway. Cola seems to just be a bit too Ibiza for me. It's playing out seems to be nothing new for CamelPhat, with 56 gigs in 2018. Well, that's according to Songkick, it may be more, but they've done loads of festivals. Especially off the back of Cola being such a huge success for them. With regards to stages, I would be really surprised if we didn't see them on the dance tent. Whilst playing the Radio 1 stage isn't out of the question, I know that Pete Tong and Annie Mack are both huge fans of theirs. And we've had a lot of dance acts on those stages, but those slots tend to be reserved for the artists that are at the height of their game and have at least one album out. Something that CamelPhat have yet to accomplish. On the likely to see scale, I'll give them a 6 out of 10. I like a couple of their songs, I think they're really cool. They're playing the Friday, so I might be really excited. If they were the Sunday, it would probably be a definite no. Who knows, they might release like the most amazing dance track this year that I just get obsessed with. But next year that I get obsessed with. But they're probably going to end up playing the dance tent, which is my least favourite stage at Reading. I think it's just the least personable stage. It's very, very crowded. It's not divided very well, but it is a dance stage and it's a good atmosphere for a dance stage, so I don't know. As I said, they're playing the Friday, I might just be really excited like I was Running Mac this year. Thoughts in the comments section below. What do you think of CamelPhat? Are they someone that you're excited to see? How likely are you to go see them at 10? And what's your favourite song by them? I think that they're a really cool duo, a really cool act, and they're clearly doing very well to be both platinum and Grammy nominated. So good on Festival Republic for that booking. But how likely are you to see them? Again, thoughts in the comment section below, and I'll see you next time. Cheers. Ha ha ha.